Hello dear students, this is our online social studies class and we are in chapter 16, Earth's Treasure, Natural Resources. And you know, we already completed the chapter. I think that whole chapter is now clear to you. And in my previous class, I already discussed about the objective type question answers on this chapter. Okay, so today I'll give you some more objective type questions and the question answers on this chapter. Before that, I'm telling you the main points once again. So the main points are: natural resources are valuable substances given to man by nature. And next point is, natural resources are of two types: renewable and non-renewable resources. Next, examples of renewable resources are sun, wind, water, soil, plants and trees, animals, etc. And they can be used again and again. And next is examples of non-renewable resources. These are coal and petroleum, minerals, etc. They are exhaustive and cannot be used again and again. And next point is, conservation of natural resources is important so that they are around in the future too. Otherwise, in future we have no such natural resources. Okay, so now come to the question answers. Firstly, some more objective type question. This is, write true for the correct statement and false for the wrong statement, and correct the false statement. Okay. Number one, if renewable resources come from non-living things, they are called organic renewable resources, and it is false statement. So what is the correct statement? The correct statement is, if renewable resources come from non-living things, they are called inorganic renewable resources. Okay. Next question two, extraction and use of non-renewable resources is very environment friendly. Answer is false. So what is the correct statement? Correct statement is, extraction and use of non-renewable resources is very polluting to the environment. Next is number three. Renewable resources can be used again and again throughout its life. It is true. We know that renewable resources, we can use them again and again. Okay. Next question four. Petroleum is an example of renewable resources. It is also a false statement. So what is the correct statement? Petroleum is an example of non-renewable resources, as it is a fossil fuel and exhaustive, so it is a non-renewable resource. Next question five. Solar energy is a low cost energy and can be easily used in homes and offices. It is a true statement. Solar energy is renewable energy. So it is a low cost energy and can be easily used in homes and offices. Next is number 6. Trees and plants take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. It is true. In this way, they can help us, and they can help us to release oxygen, they help us, and the same way they keep a balance in the atmosphere. Okay. Next is, answer the following questions. Number 1, what do you mean by resources? Answer, all the things available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs are our resources. Okay? All the things available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs are our resources. Number 2, what do you mean by natural resources? Answer, natural resources are materials from the nature that are used to support life and meet people's needs. Sunlight, air, water, wind, coal, petroleum, etc. are natural resources. Okay. Next question 3. What are the 2 main types of natural resources? Name them. Answer, natural resources can be of 2 types. They are number 1, renewable resources, and number 2, non-renewable resources. Okay. Next question 4. Differentiate between renewable and non-renewable resources. So, you have to make 2 column here. One for renewable resources and the other for non-renewable resources. Okay. So, number and then you give the points. Here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 points in all. Point number 1, what is the first difference? It is, that is for non-renewable resources. Renewable resources is present in unlimited quantity. And non-renewable resources in limited, is present in limited quantity. Non-renewable resources present in limited quantity, and here renewable resources present in unlimited quantity. Number 2, for renewable resources. Renewable resources are non-exhaustive, and here non-renewable resources are exhaustive. Okay. Next 3, point 3. Renewable resources are pollution free, and here non-renewable resources are not pollution free. Point 4. Renewable resources are cheaper, and non-renewable resources are costlier. Next 5, difference number 5. Solar energy, wind energy, etc. are example of such energy. Okay. And here coal, petroleum, minerals are example of such energy, that is non-renewable energy. Okay. So these 5, there are 5 points. You have to memorize any 3. Okay. Question 5. Describe the sun as a renewable resources. Answer. Sunlight is the most important energy today. The energy from the sun is called solar energy. In the present days, solar energy is harnessed to produce useful heat and electricity by scientists and engineers. Solar energy can be used in our daily life to cook food, heat water, run cars, and so on. Next question 6. Write a short note on wind energy. Answer: wind energy is a form of renewable energy that does not produce pollution. Large windmills are used to generate wind energy, which is later converted into electrical energy and used for various purposes. Number 7. Write a short note on soil. How is soil a living system? Answer: soil is a natural resource that helps humans, plants, animals to live on the earth. As soil supports different types of living organisms on earth, so it is a living system. Next 8. Why are plants and animals considered as renewable resources? Answer: plants provide human beings, animals with food and shelter. Plants release oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide and thus are essential for survival of us. Plants also help to conserve soil and bring rainfall. That's why they are considered as renewable resources. They can be renewed by planting more of them. Next, animals are also considered as renewable resources because they reproduce to produce offsprings who are equally useful like them. Animals provide us food, eggs, milk, meat, etc., and also used to carry loads. Next question 9. How coal and petroleum are produced? Coal and petroleum are produced by constant high pressure of earth's crust and upper soil. This pressure acts upon the fossils and residues of animals and plants over millions of years, producing petroleum and coal deposits. Question 10. Name some important minerals which are non-renewable resources. Iron ore, manganese, mica, copper, gold, and silver are some important minerals. These minerals, when extracted, are called ores. Ores are refined and converted into pure metals. 11. What steps should be taken to conserve water? Answer: we can conserve water by taking these steps. First point, using minimum amount of water and by stopping misuse them. Next point, building rainwater harvesting system to increase the groundwater level. Next point, planting more trees as they help to maintain the water cycle. Question 12. What steps should be taken to conserve soil? To conserve soil, we should, first point, plant and grow trees, herbs, and grasses in open areas to prevent soil erosion. Next point, using mixed cropping techniques so that soil nutrients are not depleted. And next point, farmers should use less pesticides and fertilizers and use natural manure. Here is 3 points, okay? Next type of question is give reasons. Number one, we should avoid the construction of dams, roads and industrial construction in forest areas. Answer, to conserve the forests and wildlife, we should avoid any construction in forest areas. Number two, power companies build dozens of wind turbines. Answer, as windmill on a farm can make only a small amount of electricity to make enough electricity to serve both of people, power companies build wind farms with dozens of wind turbines. Okay. Next. Number three, we should conserve water. Although 70% of the earth is covered with water, but only 3% is safe to drink, and that is depleting fast. So we should conserve water. Okay. So these are the questions. You all copy the questions and memorize. And that's all for today's class. Till my next class, bye. All of you stay safe.